This is See Her Gone, written by Rylie Dark and narrated by Maggie Schneider. Chapter 1. Stars Everywhere. Mary Summerhill laid back against the battered old sofa in her trailer, her fingers losing their grip on the plunger of the syringe. At that moment, the moment she injected that liquid gold into her veins, nothing else mattered but those stars. She felt herself speeding into outer space like a rocket at full speed, like going into hyperspace on Star Wars, where everything seemed to blur around her. The crash would come soon, too soon. It came quicker now. Meth had helped her to lose her flawless complexion, her smile, her job, her family, and most of her friends. But could she give it up? Did she even want to? No. She savored the feeling of weightlessness, caring about none of those things. She didn't even know what day it was, what time it was. Her shades were pulled low, as always. Mary hated the sunlight. She hated the outdoors, and with a good reason. There were people looking for her, out there. Inside, she was safe. She had a gun stashed in the coffee table, and she wasn't afraid to use it. Here, with her meth, she had everything she needed. A moment later, the curtains moved. The stars had disappeared, and the urge was back. She wanted that next hit. She scrambled off the sofa and looked at her stash. She'd gone through hell to get it. She found two sad, deflated bags with only a trace of the powder left. Funny. She'd only just gotten them. How could she have nearly blown through it all? She couldn't remember when, how, or with whom. Damn it, she thought. Mick was all the way at the other end of the town, and she probably wasn't his favorite person right now. She'd slept with him and all of his friends. Nameless, faceless guys she wouldn't even know if she saw them in broad daylight. To earn a bag. But when they left and she saw it all there, laid out in front of her, she was like a kid in a candy store. She'd taken two, figuring he had so many he probably didn't count them. But Mick wasn't an idiot. He was a businessman, first and foremost. So maybe he did count them. And he definitely wasn't the kind of person you wanted to piss off. She shouldn't have done it. It was too big a risk. But right then, she wished she'd taken three bags. She leaned over the coffee table, trying to see if she could arrange enough of the white powder to give herself another hit. As she was trying to scrape it together, she heard tires, kicking up gravel in front of the house. The beam from headlights slashed across her line of vision. Mary stood up, grabbed the gun, and went to the door, just as someone began to bang on it. Mary, I know you're in there. It was Mick. She looked around at the two empty bags on the table. Quickly, she scooped them up and shoved them in a drawer, then went to the door. Mary! Go away, Mick. I'm warning you, she called out. I'm not leaving until I get my money. That was the truth. If Mick was anything, it was persistent. She wouldn't get rid of him until she gave him something. She opened the door and smiled in response to his scowl. Mick looked scarier than usual, with his shaved head, tattooed neck, and red scar running from temple to chin. His black eyes focused on her, his pierced lip curled into a snarl, and he held out a big hand, waiting for her to drop something into it. Hi, she said innocently, slapping his palm. Are you looking for more fun? He scowled and ran his eye around the place. Don't give me that bullshit. You took an extra bag from my stash. I want it back. She widened her eyes innocently. I don't know what you're talking about. I took one bag, and that's paid in full. Like hell you did. You took two, I know. I just counted them right before you got there. She tossed her blonde hair over her shoulder and folded her arms over her tank top. If you're missing some, don't look at me. It must have been one of your friends. It's you. He pushed open the door, shoving her out of the way. But she met him with the gun, pointing it at his chest. Get out. He lifted his hands once more. Hey, watch it. You watch it. She shouted, and he took a step back, then another, until he stumbled on the front steps. I want you out of here.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.